We are about to bust the most popular myth about roulette, that you can't win because the casino has the mathematical advantage. Are you ready?
There is a myth built around the so-called house edge in roulette. It's time to dispel it for once and for all. So this is going to be the definitive text about the house edge in roulette. A monograph that clearly and fully explains what is the house edge, the theoretical arguments built on it, and the reality of how it actually affects your play and winnings at the roulette tables. So can the house edge destroy your strategy? Why is it so difficult to win at roulette? If you pose that question to a mathematician or post it into a gambler's forum, the usual answer you'll get is that roulette is not just difficult, but impossible to beat in the long run. Now, no one would doubt that you can win at roulette in a couple of visits to the casino, but they are sure that you cannot stay in profit for too long. Hey, I've got a nice bet selection and great progression, so maybe I can be profitable, you might say. No chance, they would answer. Either you use a refined system or throw your chips at random numbers, the outcome, according to those guys, will be the same, a loss. Not only do they know that you'll lose in the long run, they also know how much you will lose. 2.7% of your bets. Yep, no matter how you play, in the long run, you'll be in loss for 2.7% of the total amount of money you ever bet on roulette. If you ask them how do they know the outcome beforehand and why they're so sure of it, they will answer monotonously, "It's the house advantage, stupid." But they're wrong. The house edge is not the real reason we lose at roulette.
The concept of house advantage. The main idea behind the house advantage, or house edge, or player disadvantage, or average expectation, they all refer to the same thing, is that the casinos need to make money. Therefore, every casino game has a specific house advantage, depending on the type of the game, roulette, blackjack, craps, Texas Hold'em, etc. Theoretically, the house advantage is the amount of money the casino is making for itself, while the rest of it is given back to the players by paying out their wins. Roulette house edge explained. Let's be more specific. As you know, European roulette has, on the table layout and on the actual roulette wheel, the 37 numbers from 0 to 36. Of these 37 numbers, the 36, 1 through 36, are colored black or red, and the 0 is colored green. The green 0 symbolizes the house edge, and I say it symbolizes and not it is the house edge, because if we want, we can freely bet on the 0 and get a profit from it. But the point is that although the roulette wheel and table have 37 numbers and 37 discrete possible outcomes, we are paid as if it had only 36. This means that our payout in a case of a win is 1 over 37, which equals 2.7% lower than it should. When you bet on red even chance, it is actually not exactly an even chance, since on the wheel there are 18 red numbers, 18 black numbers, and 1 0. So you have an 18 over 37, or a 48.7% chance of winning, and not 50%. Therefore, your payout should have been 37 minus 18 divided by 18, which equals 19 over 18, which equals 102.7% of your bet. But you are paid only 100% of your bet. When you bet a single number, your chance of winning is 1 in 37, or 2.7%, and your payout should have been 37 minus 1 over 1, which equals 36, which equals 360%, or 36 times your bet. But you are paid only 350%, or 35 times your bet. This is a 2.7% difference of the ideal payout. There is no doubt, although the roulette wheel has 37 numbers, casinos pay us as if roulette only had 36 numbers, and this means they pay us 2.7% less than it is fair. This unfair 2.7% goes to the casino to pay their bills, and this is the so-called house edge or house advantage. The bad mathematician speaks. Average expectation. The mathematicians take the concept of the house edge to a whole new level, and they conclude that it is impossible to win at roulette in the long run. Their reasoning is as follows. No matter what is your roulette strategy, the house advantage cannot be negated. It is always there, no matter what combination of bets you choose. Let's say, for example, that you bet $5 on 0 and $20 on 2 dozens. This is 68% probability of winning, but let's calculate the risk/reward relation. You have 1 in 37 chance of winning, $135 for the 0, a 24 in 37 chance of winning $15 for the 2 dozens, and 12 of 37% chance of losing, $45 for the 3rd dozen. The overall expected return or expected value is 1 over 37 times 135 plus 24 over 37 times 15 minus 12 over 37 times 45 all divided by 45, which equals a negative 2.7%. So they prove that the player disadvantage is there, steady at negative 2.7% on every bet. And therefore, they arbitrarily conclude that roulette strategies or progressions or bet selections make no difference and offer no advantage. Then, they go a bit further and they say, arbitrarily again, that since every bet on the roulette table has a negative average value, negative 2.7%, then in the end, in the long run, one will inevitably lose an amount of money on the average, equal to 2.7% of all his life bets. They call that average expectation. Their verdict? You cannot win at roulette, because it is a negative expectation game. Now, let's see why they are wrong, why this is too much narrow-minded mathematics and too little real life.
See, the house edge is no big deal. I want to emphasize the house advantage is a considerable disadvantage for any roulette player. It eats up part of our winnings. And yes, if it didn't exist, our lives as gamblers would be much easier. But generally speaking, its significance is greatly overstated. It's not the be-all and end-all ultimate player killer, and its existence constitutes no proof that one cannot be profitable with the ideal strategy. Now here's why. There is not, and there can never be, any mathematical proof that a roulette strategy cannot be profitable. Now this is impossible because roulette is a random game, and none can guarantee, let alone prove, that you will lose. So you can think of the house edge as a minimal 2.7% tax, automatically applied on your one money every time you win. To make some analogies to the real world, the math boy's argument is like saying that you cannot be profitable in business because you have to pay taxes. Well, of course, taxes decrease your profit, but they can't stop you being profitable. It's also like saying that you can't make money in the stock market because you have to pay a commission for every transaction. Do you start to see the nonsense of this way of thinking? See, the mathematical approach ignores blatantly any strategy applied by the player. Either you throw the chips randomly on the table or you play with discipline a very well thought out roulette system, it's considered absolutely the same thing by the house advantage advocates. Progression, stop loss, personal permanence, trigger events, bet selection, all these parameters leave them cold. If you play roulette, you play roulette. How you play it makes no difference. But see, that's simply not true. The truth is, because it's not easy to mathematically evaluate the merit of a roulette strategy and put a specific numerical value to it, they simply choose to ignore this parameter altogether. Now, what also strikes me as amazing is the blind belief in probability expectations, when we all know that reality can vary greatly from the theoretically expected results. Be sure, you cannot win at roulette just because there is a 2.7% house advantage or player disadvantage. It's like believing that in 111 roulette spins there will be exactly 54 reds, 54 blacks, and 3 zeros, just because that's the theoretical expectation. Now this is not only wrong, it's also a contradiction from the math guys. They often tell us that every spin is independent and nothing is due, and extreme variations from the average, even after thousands of spins, are perfectly normal. Yet they religiously believe in the 2.7% disadvantage, making us lose like probabilistic zealots. I've never met a gambler who has lost in his gambling life an amount equal to the house advantage, 2.7% of his total bets. Most of them have lost much more, and some have lost much less. And I've stopped caring so much about the result of testing millions of spins because I don't plan to play a million spins in my lifetime. If you told me today there will be 95 reds, 100 blacks, and 6 greens, I could bet on red with the proper money management and finish the session with profit. And the odds would be against me more than 2.7%. This scenario is not a big problem. So to finish this issue once and for all, this is my challenge to all the house edge obsessed gentlemen. Show me a system that would win if there was no house edge. I dare anyone to show me a system that could beat roulette if there was an edge in favor of the player. Say you don't lose your money when zero comes, and you gain a chip bonus for every 100 spins played. Now show me a system that will win with these favorable conditions. Hey, not a system that's going to win after 5 million spins, but a system that I could play, say for 10 days, 100 spins a day, and be 100% sure that in total I will come out ahead after the last day. This means a system that will generate profit in real life. If you could give me such a system, I most certainly could turn it to a successful system taking into account the house edge. It's not the house edge that's the problem. How else can I explain this to you? So why then do we lose? If the negative expectation is not such a big issue, then why do we lose at roulette? Well, that's a valid question. Indeed, the extreme difficulty to be profitable in roulette is one of the reasons why the house edge myth is so popular. It's the easy and scientific explanation for why we lose. However, it's not the true and complete explanation. Yes, the house advantage doesn't make it easier, but it can be overcome with a nice progression. The main reason for the losses of most serious and thoughtful roulette players is something totally different. It's the variance from the average, the difference between theoretical expectations and actual outcomes, the extreme fluctuations. That is the reason why we lose. We lose because sometimes we experience crazy spin sequences that fall in the tails of the normal distribution graph. You just can't beat those roulette spins from hell. It's often said that even the best roulette strategy cannot negate the 2.7% average expectation. But the point of a good system is to overcome a 10 or 20% disadvantage due to variance. Compared to that, the 2.7% is peanuts.
Variance from the average. If there was no zero and no house edge, if you bet on black, in 100 spins, you could theoretically expect 50 blacks plus 50 reds. You would have 50% wins. With the introduction of zero, you expect roughly 48 blacks and 49 reds and 3 greens. You would have 48% wins, less than 50%, but no big deal. There are many progressions that can produce profit with 48% win rates. The real problem, and the reason we could always lose at roulette, is that no matter what the theoretical expectation, it is possible to have a 100 spin sequence with only 37 blacks, which is a mere 37% win rate. Now that's difficult to beat, and this has nothing to do with the house edge. Such a low hit rate would be possible even if there was no zero and no house edge.
So listen, the house edge in roulette is a reality. The roulette player, every time he wins, is being paid 2.7% less than he should. However, that is by no means proof that he cannot be profitable with the right strategy. And anyway, the house advantage is a minor issue compared with much more important issues the roulette player has to deal with, like the variance of the expected average of spin outcomes.
The mathematics of American roulette. Expected value. Now, American roulette has two zeros, 0 and double 0, and 38 numbers in total. The payout is exactly the same, but the house advantage on the double 0 roulette is 2 of 38, which equals 5.3%, much worse than that of European roulette. The logic of the arguments we presented hold true even for the American wheel. The 5.3% disadvantage of the player is a considerable handicap. But it is still not enough reason to totally dismiss the possibility of winning at roulette with the appropriate strategy. That's all about the house edge in roulette. If you agree or disagree with something we said, we would love to read your comments. If you liked our video, please like, share, and subscribe.
If this was useful to you, please don't forget to subscribe, share, and like our video. Now, maybe it's time to get your play to the next level with the great strategies you will find in our site, or watch another one of our videos.